Have you been enjoying meeting UK fans?
I'm loving it. Yeah, I'm surprised how many different, all shapes, sizes, people that are coming from all over the place to come and meet us. It's really good. I'm very happy that we've got that many fans here as well. It's a good thing for our show.
For anyone who hasn't discovered the show yet, can you kick us off with a quick synopsis? Because it's a unique premise for the series, really, in so many ways.
Yeah, it is unique. I'd compare it in its style to something like Misfits, which is set in a realistic world, modern day, but it has a science fiction aspect to it. So for us, it's a family of four brothers and their grandfather living in modern day New Zealand. They're all a bit average at what they do, and they happen to be Norse gods, reincarnations of Norse gods. So my character is the big kahuna of the gods, and the comedy and the drama comes out of him trying to figure his world out through that. We see Thor, which is a very different Thor from what anyone is used to seeing. My character is Odin, which is the top god. We have Ull, we have Hod and Balder. We have Loki. Some less known and a lot of the very, very known ones. And we all have small powers or huge powers, whether it be lighting things on fire, throwing hammers for kilometres and killing goats, or being able to transform into women.
Yeah. That's a slightly unique power to have. How does it manifest itself in the series? How useful does your character find that ability?
Very useful in terms of story and him learning about what he needs to learn about, but in terms of waking up as a woman, he's quite frightened and amazed. But it's very useful for him. Yeah, the ability to shapeshift. Well, you do see me in a dress, but in terms of when I do actually shapeshift, I transform into a lovely actress called Siobhan Marshall, who's a big deal in New Zealand, and same height. Convenient. Yes, so it's not me in many hours of drag and makeup. It's a lovely lady.
I was going to say, because from the footage we've seen, you look much prettier in some of those scenes than I would have thought you in a dress would necessarily.
But. Yeah, my beautiful blonde locks, I know. Yeah, I am a woman in those scenes. And I'm actually on the sidelines helping her with Axel's characteristics and little bits of mannerisms that he has and ways he says things. But it's definitely not me.
Going to say, I mean, obviously it's interesting in a way because you're kind of sharing the character and how much time you spend kind of talking about, you know, oh, well, I think he'd do this in this scene and, you know.
Well, when I'm playing him, I just do my thing. But when she's playing, we spent about 2 or 3 days workshopping, her following me around, her watching me, her going through the entire DVDs, the whole, how many did we have? Yeah, however many episodes it was until that point. So she really studied a lot of it and I was on the sidelines just throwing things, you know, because a woman has to learn how to sit like a guy, which is legs apart with their hands on their knees. Very different from what women are used to, or this woman anyway. So it was a bit of trial and error. There's a few episodes in between the three seasons that involve Axel as Odin and a guy called Jeff Dolan who plays Thor, and just the comedy in that, the heart that's in that, plus the Norse mythology in that, it's a really good combination of what I think our show does best, which is never takes itself too seriously, but when it needs to, it does.
Obviously, I think the series is starting to get picked up more and more for international distribution. Yeah. How do you think a wider audience, I mean, obviously, because it's a very unique fusion to begin with, I mean, Norse mythology and, you know, New Zealand cultural reference points. How do you think that's going to translate to people here in the UK, for example?
Well, it seems to have gone well. I think there's something in it for everyone, and for a lot of the fans here, it is that Norse mythology, or it's the fact that Grandpa is bald and good-looking, or it's that it's a family relationship and people can relate to that. So I think there's something in it for everyone, and the fans that have come today seem quite big on Norse mythology, which is quite satisfying for me because I learnt everything that I know about Norse mythology through the Almighty Johnsons, so the fact that they have extended their knowledge of it through our show is quite special. It's good.
Is there another Norse god that you're especially fond of on the series?
Fond of? I love Anders. I love Dino Gorman as an actor and as a person. And I enjoy the attitude that his character has. And I also... Yeah, I really like Thor. He's great. Derek is just, he's a sheep goat farmer from the middle of nowhere, and he's just hilarious. So watching him, working with him, reading the scripts, that things that he has to say, just a real pleasure. Well, we don't know about season 4 yet. It's always with New Zealand stuff, it's always up in the air. But next, I'm on my way to LA actually next week. So I'll be there for the next sort of 6 months or so, doing my best to promo the show when it starts in January. So who knows where I'll be next. You guys are the best. I really appreciate it, everything that we've put into it. It's been so special that you have responded the way you have. And for those of you that haven't seen it, enjoy.